Hello everyone, and welcome to the Extreme TIG channel, guys. Hope everyone is doing good and well. For today's video, I got a 10-inch butt weld. It's set up in the position. As you can see here, it's set up with the rigging. It's attached to the crane. It's about to tack. So I'm just gonna show you a little bit how it's set up. It's up on a scaffold. It's a little bit offset that line. Just gonna show you the closer look. I got chain grips around with that angle iron just to keep that spool in place for any high lows. There's a little bit of view from my scaffold deck. As I said, you see it's secured on a crane, so it doesn't move, stays in the place. Once I got filled to flush, then we're gonna remove all that rigging. So I got the gap rod inside. It's a 532. It's not really even all the way around. It's okay, but it's not perfect. There's not much. There's lots of room, but shouldn't be big. It's not a big deal. Okay, as I said, it's a 532 to loose 1/8 on some spots. I'm gonna try open up a little bit on the bottom so it doesn't close. As I wanna do first tack on the bottom. It's gonna be three tacks, one on the bottom, one on the side, and one on the top. Then we can remove all that stuff around that joint. Okay, this is on the top tack, double root tacks. I got one on the top, one on the 9 o'clock, and one on the bottom, 6 o'clock. As you can see, the prep inside, it's nice and clean. Always go a couple inches from that edge. You wanna prep is 50% of the job. You want to have really good prep, guys. Always clean. 136 with Miller XMT. 136 amps. I'm gonna start on the bottom. I'm just thinking, what technique should I use? Should I go walk the cup or freehand or back feed or lay wire or combination of everything together? As I got lots of room, but still on the sides between that T and the flange. There's not much room, and standing on that scaffold, it's gonna be a little bit hard to backfeed. So I'm just gonna, I think, walk the cup and keep the rod under angle. Okay, as you can see, I feather out that tack, and now I'm just gonna push that rod in and keep the rod inside for the root. Keep that rod connected all the time, and try to have as last stops as you can. So to have nice consistent root, you have to have minimum stops. You don't want to stop too much. Every time you stop, it's visible, and then it's going to be uneven spots. I've seen some of you guys email me and send me your works to see what you guys are doing wrong, and this is one of the things I really noticed. And lots of you guys, lots of stops. Try to practice that to have less stops, especially on a smaller inch, smaller diameter pipes. 6 inch, you should have only 2 stops, or only on the tacks. Wherever it's tack, you have to stop, of course. Like, try to practice that. That's how you're gonna get nice consistent root with less stops. Okay, this is the bottom section. It's already done. This is the root. You know, I like bigger, heavier root, especially at the bottom, especially at the bottom section, to prevent any suck back. As I like to run hot pass, really hot. Same thing. Grind stop starts, as this joint is gonna be X-rayed, so I'm just gonna pay a little bit more attention to it, just a little more careful. Now I'm gonna switch to dipping technique. As on this side, I had a little bit high-low. Not much, but as for any high-lows, I like to use dipping techniques. Dipping rod, you can see both sides, both edges got burned, and you can see the amount that you're actually putting in, so you can kind of control that buildup. Just pay attention on your inclination of that tungsten. Okay, this side already half up to 3 o'clock. It's already done. We're just gonna go from here, grind stop starts, and go up to that to the top. Just gonna stop before that tack on the top. Okay, this is route so far from 6 to 3 o'clock. With this route, no worries, shouldn't be any issues with as you can see here, only 2 stops. As I say, try to go less stops as you can. Something to practice. And grind stop starts. Just got issue with the lighting, but I got really good light setup, so it's really bright. Okay, I don't know, did I mention 1/8 TIG filler wire, 70S6. I'm just gonna continue on, and I'm gonna stop at the top before the attack. The reason why I'm gonna stop and I didn't do feather out the attack, just want to show you guys they actually how I'm doing tie-in. And you can see here the stretch, the scratch start. Do I prefer scratch start over lifting arc? I don't know, it's probably more habit with the scratch start. Just gotta have that sense. You don't wanna hammer that tungsten in the root or broke that tip. You just want to scratch it nice. It's like firing the match, eh? Pretty much the same thing, nice and gentle. Okay, now we're gonna feather out. Well, I got some little bit issue with the breeze coming here. There's a fence close by, and that just breeze coming in here, so I had to put that screen, but it looks okay. If you got lighter, you can check it up always around your joint if any breeze is coming, so you can put some extra protection. And that's it, pretty much. This is how I do the. This is how I feather out the tacks for the tie-in. I'm just gonna dip in the middle, stretch that puddle. Before I reach that tack, I'm just gonna slow down and pause. You pause a little bit on the sides, and then on the other side, and then just adding wire while you're going over, and stop right in the middle. And the reason why I got feathered out the way I do, it's so I can connect when I'm going on the other side. Okay, this is the half of the route done, half of the spool is finished. Looks alright, I like it. Okay, now on this side, it closed, the gap closed a little bit, so I can put 1/8 inside. Like if I want to, I can crank up a little bit more amps. I can go dipping technique. The way there is a couple ways I can push that filler wire inside. But just for the purpose of this video, I want to show you guys the proper steps. Don't be lazy. You got tools. You got technology. Use it. Open up that gap. Try to leave feather edges. And for feather edge, you kind of want to open up under angle, as you can see here. You're shaving that bevel, but you're still leaving that feather edge. And once you got enough, now I got loose 1/8, and that should be good. So I can feed rod inside. As I said, bottom section is most important for me. I mean, it's important all the way around, but I like it to have. You want to have nice and good start. That's always usually on the bottom. So if you got nice and good solid root, it's easier just to follow the same thickness, the same build up all the way around. Okay, the same thing, keep the rod inside. Just gonna walk the cap here. Keep the rod inside, keep that inclination, keep an eye on the paddle. You don't wanna have tungsten inclusion, don't want to push tungsten in that puddle too much. Just stretch it. Just feed enough rod. You don't want to lose. You don't want to lose connections. Just keep it connected all the time. This is gonna give you a good idea how much buildup you got already inside. As you can see on the side on the puddle, you always have to watch how the puddle behaves. Okay, this is the bottom part, and it looks good. That was the idea. That was the goal. Now we're just gonna continue on. The gap looks good and even. I'm just gonna continue on keeping that rod inside. While I'm going up around 9 o'clock, after I pass that tack, I'm just gonna pull it out slowly from the outside. I'm not gonna keep that rod inside, and the rest will, the gravity will do. Just want to keep it out, especially when you're going on the top. You can switch to dipping, or you can dip in the middle and 1, 2, 3. Okay, now we reach the top. As I already did, I feather out that the top part. Now we're just gonna connect that tie in. Okay, this chilling out a little bit here. I'm just stretching my legs. Okay, I'm just gonna finish here, do the tie-in. As you can see, actually it's not much you can see from this angle, but this is the best I did, the best I could. I just dip in the middle, stretch, 1, 2, 3, dip in the middle, 1, 2, 3. This is how you stretch on the side, you know, especially on the top. As I said, the gravity will do the rest. You don't have to be worried about the build up inside. You're gonna have a nice you're gonna have lots of protrusion inside. Bruffing wheel, clean every pass, every time. You want to have everything nice and clean before every pass. You don't want to have any impurities. Now we're just gonna do hot pass. Okay, same stick out pretty much, up to 10 mil, just a new tungsten, nice and clean, sharp. I'm running around 150 amps for the hot pass. Hot pass, pretty simple, just keep that rod in the middle, stretch that puddle. Okay, this side is done. I'm gonna finish other side. Okay, now we got both sides done. Same thing, buffing wheel. And now we're gonna fill to flush. Probably I'm gonna do two more passes until it's filled to flush. As I said, it's gonna be x-rayed, so. Okay, now. If it's filled to flush, just use my magic wand. Okay, at this point we can take that rigging off, take it off out of that crane. It was just to hold that spool in place. It was just safe. Okay, 175. This is what I'm gonna use for the capping. I'm gonna switch to the cup size 10. Same stick out for tungsten. Up to 10 mil, and just side to side motion. Nice, roll that cup from one edge to another. Try to keep the straight edge. It's the fastest way if you can walk the cup for your capping, especially with the higher amps. This, as you already know my story, this is torch only 150 rated, but 175 should be fine. I do half of the spool, then I let it cool down a little bit. and then I go do other side. Okay, this is for the capping. Just keep the rod connected, keep it in the middle, stretch that paddle, push as needed. And that's it pretty much, guys. The capping is done. As you can see, I stopped only 3 times on each side, as that there's not much room between that flange and the joint. Since I have to stop, there's not much room to push my head. And that's it. For today's video. Hope you guys like it. Enjoy it. Just a little bit, show you what I'm doing in the field weld, and see you in the next one. Take care, guys. Thanks for watching.